Good evening and welcome to Equine Essentials. I'm your host, Gray Parks, Equine Nutritionist for ProTrition Feed. And I'm here with you tonight to talk about feeding strategies that will help prevent choke in your horses. This is a very timely topic. I've had several horse owner phone calls in the last week or two about horses choking on all different kinds and types and amounts of feed. And I think a big part of that is this time of year, even if we look out into our pastures and it looks like horses have plenty of grass out there, as dry as it's been in the months of September and October, there's not a lot of actually palatable, useful, nutritious grass right at this moment in time. So your horses are probably consuming less of their pasture because it is a little more fibrous and a little drier than normal. When you bring them their feed, they're very hungry, very excited, and we're getting an increased number of chokes in horses without a history and on products that have no history of causing choke. So I want to talk with everyone tonight about what we can do when we're feeding horses that have a history of choke or that are at high risk of choking to help prevent that and reduce the chances of your horse choking in the future. So what is choke? Choke in a horse is when something is lodged in the horse's esophagus, so the tube that runs from the mouth down to the stomach. Now in horses, unlike in humans, the esophagus is completely separate from the trachea. So a horse that's choking can still breathe. Therefore, the choke itself is not necessarily a life-threatening emergency. The horse may be very distressed, it may be uncomfortable, but it can still breathe. So it's not the same as a human where you can be in a life or death situation with a choke. Now, choke can become an issue over and over again because as you can see in this diagram, the horse's esophagus is fairly narrow and a horse that has choked before will build up scar tissue often and then that makes the horse more likely to choke in the future. What kinds of horses choke? Well, we're going to talk about that momentarily, but the most important thing to keep in mind is what you should do in that moment when the horse is choking. I am not a veterinarian. I'm not here to give you medical treatment advice, but I did want to talk a little bit about triaging a choke and what you should and shouldn't do while you're waiting to talk to your vet or waiting for your vet to arrive in the case of a choke. A lot of horses will resolve a choke on their own. In fact, I think a lot more horses probably have mild chokes that we don't ever see because they do resolve them so quickly. But when a horse is choking, you might see the horse coughing, gagging, they might get really distressed. I've seen them actually roll as if they were colicking just because they're a little bit panicked by the feeling of choking. Or they may be standing quietly and depressed in their stall, and that's actually the better scenario in this case. The very first thing you should do is call your veterinarian and let them know what's going on. You and or the horse may be able to get the choke resolved quickly, but you may not, and you want your veterinarian in the loop and also to give you any instructions regarding medications they may or may not want you to administer to the horse, such as a sedative and or an anti-inflammatory like Banamine. In the meantime, you should also remove all feed and water from the horse while it's choking. Some of them will continue to try to eat and drink while they're choking, and that can be a problem because the biggest and most serious complication from choke is something called aspiration pneumonia. As we talked about on the previous slide, horses who are choking can still breathe, so they're not going to suffocate while they're choking. However, they might inadvertently inhale feed particles, and if those particles or saliva or any liquid gets into the lungs, then the horses can develop something called aspiration pneumonia. And that's what we're trying to avoid in keeping the horse quiet and calm during a choke. You want the horse to stand with his head low if possible, so those feed particles are draining down out of the nostrils and not being inhaled by the horse. In some cases, a very mild choke, that might be enough to help the horse clear the choke by itself. If not, you'll at least have kept the horse as comfortable as possible and as least likely to aspirate as possible while you're waiting on your veterinarian. A very important what not to do with a choking horse is you never, ever, ever want to try to force the choke to clear yourself by administering water or mineral oil or any type of liquid via a syringe, a water hose, or a tube yourself, because there's a high likelihood of causing aspiration pneumonia in that particular case. So call your vet, get their instructions, and try to keep your horse quiet and calm to allow the choke to have the best chance of clearing. As far as the horses that are more likely to choke, there are certain risk factors that up a horse's likelihood of choking. The first is age. Very young horses, so those under 5, and old horses over 15 to 20, depending on their individual aging rate, are more likely to choke. And that has to do with the second bullet point here, their dental health. Young and old horses are more likely to have dental challenges than adult horses. But adult horses, particularly those who are fed from elevated feeders, who eat a lot of grain and little grass, are also potentially having dental issues that can change the way the horse chews and therefore make the horse more likely to choke. Horses that are very aggressive or enthusiastic eaters, horses that bolt or gulp their feed without chewing, are more likely to choke than those that are slow chewers that take their time eating. One of the biggest contributing factors I witness a lot in the field is horses that are fed in group settings. So you have horses that are in a paddock or pasture and they're all fed kind of in a row along the fence, are often being set up for a potential choke because there's a lot more anxiety and need to eat quickly feeling on the horse's part when they're eating in a group. So those horses might tend to take big mouthfuls, gulp their feed down, and not chew well and therefore choke. Horses that are fed large, infrequent meals versus multiple small meals are more likely to choke. Again, for two reasons. One, them being kind of anxious and excited to get the feed, and also having large amounts of feed, they can take bigger mouthfuls and therefore could be more likely to choke. Horses fed from chest height or higher, so elevated feeders, are more likely to choke for a couple of reasons. One being that the angle of their jaw will be different when they're eating up here versus on the ground. And so those horses might not chew as well. Additionally, you're gonna wear their teeth differently when they're eating from an elevated position instead of on the ground, and therefore kind of doubling up on choke risk factors. And the biggest risk factor for a horse's likelihood of choking is a history of previous choke. As we already discussed, when horses build scar tissue in their esophagus, they're much more likely to choke in the future. So it's very important to treat a horse that has choked in the past as a high risk for a potential future choke. So how can we manage these horses? The number one thing is to make sure your horse is receiving regular, thorough dental care from your veterinarian. We have two pictures of the types of challenges you might see in old horses on the top picture and young horses on the bottom picture. Old horses have a finite amount of tooth, and at some point they can run out of teeth. So you'll have missing teeth, you'll have completely worn down teeth. If one tooth is worn down, the opposite tooth will overgrow. You can get sharp hooks that can cause discomfort and also limit the horse's range of motion in their jaw. With young horses, as they're losing their baby teeth and being replaced by adult teeth, the adult tooth is coming up through the jaw and displacing the baby tooth. Often that baby tooth or cap can be retained or stuck on the end of the adult tooth, which again is uncomfortable for the young horse, could make it difficult for the horse to chew. And so part of their dental work will be, as you see in the bottom photo, a veterinarian actually removing those retained or stuck caps to help make the horse more comfortable when it chews. So for these older horses and younger horses, you want to make sure they're receiving a thorough examination by your veterinarian twice a year. And it's really important that it's your veterinarian who is qualified in dental work to provide this care, because you need a speculum to be able to see the far back reaches of the horse's mouth. So if you're using someone who's checking by feel, by sticking their hand into the horse's molars, it's unlikely that they're getting a thorough picture of that horse's dental health, which means that a speculum is needed. And for most horses, that means sedation, which means a veterinarian out to do that. For horses that are in that middle-aged adult range, usually once a year is sufficient for dental examination. The more the horse is grazing in pasture and the less it's eating grain and hay in a stall, then the longer it's likely to be able to go between dental treatments, but you still want to look at that horse every year and make sure nothing has come up between exams. And then we want to make feeding a time where horses don't feel the need to bolt down their feed. So when at all possible, you want to feed horses in individual pens or stalls. There are a lot of ways this can be done. This picture that I found is a really great way to do that in a pasture setting, because not only do the horses have their own spaces, but they have visual barriers between their heads so that the more aggressive horses can't intimidate the more passive horses, causing the passive horses to feel the need to bolt their feed. And again, multiple small meals per day is always very important. For particularly aggressive horses at feeding time or horses with a history of choke, one simple but very effective management change you can make is feeding hay before you feed grain. Most of us, and I'm one of those, right, will go into the field or the barn, feed grain first, and then put out hay while the horses are eating, which is fine for normal horses. But for horses that are prone to choke, if you put hay out before their grain, they're less excited. They'll be busy eating their hay and less likely to choke on their grain as a result. What kind of feeder you use can also affect your horse's likelihood of choking. Horses that are fed from an elevated feeder that's narrow and deep, like a 5-gallon bucket on the wall, are more likely to choke because they can reach in and get a big mouthful of feed in that scenario, and because their head is elevated. So if at all possible, you want to use a low, wide feeder placed on the ground. Now, not everyone can use a feeder on the ground. Maybe your horses are pawers, they tend to flip their feeders, but the lower you can safely hang your wall feeders, the better off you will be. There are a few different ideas in this slide of how you can accommodate a horse. One really easy one is to use a shallow water tank instead of a feed tub on the ground for horses to feed, to eat out of, because the feed will spread out over a larger surface area, which means the horse has to kind of chase his feed around the feeder. The top left photo is one that I had not ever seen before, but it's brilliant. This person actually used a car floor mat that has a lot of texture, put the feed on it so the horse has to kind of pick out its feed from between the crevices, which slows them down tremendously and makes them have to work a little bit. The bottom photo, the bottom right photo, is a feeder called a prevent feeder that has small little cups at the bottom of the feeder so the horse, again, can't take big mouthfuls. You can also make your own version of that by placing large smooth rocks or bricks, or I use salt blocks, in your feeder. So again, the horse has to eat around it and can't really just gobble up all of his feed in one mouthful. There are a lot of myths and misconceptions about the types of feed that are more likely to cause choke. And while we don't actually see that in a research setting, for example, that pellets versus textured versus hay pellets versus hay cubes making a big difference, I always say for a horse that has choked before, everything gets fed as soup no matter what. There's really no downside except for the time it takes to soak feed. You're getting extra water in your horse and it just gives you an extra layer of assurance. You can do that to the horse's taste, which takes some experimentation. Some horses like a big soupy gruel with lots of water. Some horses won't eat their feed if it's that wet and you can only go down to a moistened cereal texture. But adding water is the most important thing, making it almost impossible. I won't say completely because I have seen horses choke on mash as well, but significantly reducing the likelihood of that horse being able to choke. It will also take them longer to eat that mash feed, which again is a bonus with these types of horses. Hopefully, we've given you lots of strategies that you can implement tonight to ease your mind and help reduce your horse's likelihood of a choke on their feed. As always, I'm watching this video live with you tonight. If you have questions, you can post those in the comments or feel free to email me at gray.parks@protritionfeed.com. Thank you, and I hope to see you all again next month.